And welcome, children, to social studies classes of standard 5. And today we will be studying about our environment. We have been quite often talking about the environment, talking about the surroundings. So, actually, what do we understand when we hear the word environment? It's such a big term, right? So, all of us have a preconceived idea. What I believe is, all of us feel that environment is our surrounding. We will begin the chapter and we will learn about completely our environment and how we can manage things in our day-to-day lives with the things that we use daily. Let me introduce you to environment. So, environment means the surroundings or conditions in which a person, animal or plant lives or operates. Everything surrounding us and affecting us is called environment. It includes both living and non-living things. All living things depend on their environment for their survival. Air, water, and sunlight are non-living things, but they are required by living things like human beings and plants to survive. So children, what do we understand here when we see things, when we are reading, when we are going through the chapter, what are we understanding? A place or surrounding where person, animal or plant lives or operates. By operates, what we mean is by functioning. Alright, so the way they function. Where do they function? They function in the environment. So everything that affects us, the surroundings that affects us, is called environment. It says it includes both living and non-living things, which all of you believe. Even I believe that yes, everything, living and non-living things, are present in this environment itself. And we all depend on each other for our survival. Now, living things. We need so many things for our survival, like air, right? If there is no air, what will we breathe in? We need oxygen. We need water for our survival. Yes, sunlight. Sunlight has some vitamins. We need them for our growth. For so many other reasons, we depend on so many other things which are non-living, but they are of so much necessity. Going further, what do we see? A clean and healthy environment upon which life of human beings, plants and animals itself depends deserves much more importance today. So we need a very healthy and clean environment, right? The importance of the environment that we see, our dependence on it completely. Next, what do we see? Human activities and environment. What are these human activities that we are talking about here? Human greed is exploiting the natural resources and causing air, water and soil pollution. What is human greed, children? Human greed, the greed of building many more new companies to earn more, right? Building new things, creating, taking up lot of space in the soil, right? Spoiling the soil. So many other things are there which are causing pollution to the air, to the water, to the soil. It is causing immense damage to the environment on our planet. Each one of us should try to protect our environment so that our future generations too can enjoy the natural resources of the earth. Otherwise, what would happen? Gradually, the natural resources would get over. We will see what a waste is. What do we understand by waste? Your book says, all material things that we use end up as a waste. So after we use certain things, it becomes a waste. For example, when you are peeling a potato, let me take example of potato. What is the peel? Can you eat a ready peel? Can you cook the peel? Of course not. What do? You will throw it away. So that is a waste. When we bring something from a market, when we buy something from a market, we bring in clothes from market, it comes in cartons, nice wrappings. What are they? They are waste. All we would use is the cloth that is in inside that. In fact, after wearing those clothes for quite some time, even that will become a waste, right? So what are these types of waste? We will learn about it in this particular topic. Whether it is the toys that we play with, books and magazines that we read, food that we eat, TVs and radios that we play, clothes that we wear, and appliances that we use, everything ends up as a waste. So the result of everything, usage after usage, is what is a waste. First type of waste is solid waste. Any waste which is in solid form and needs to be disposed of is called solid waste. Solid waste can be any trash, garbage, or refuse that we make in our homes, offices, markets, restaurants, playgrounds, recreation centers, industries, hospitals, and other places. These include old car tires, old books, and newspapers, paper and cardboard boxes, broken furniture and appliances, clothes and food waste. So children, see, these are all solid waste, things which you can take in your hand. They have a proper shape. So what are they? They come under the category of solid waste. Moving forward, we have liquid waste. Now what is liquid waste? Any waste which is in the liquid form and needs to be disposed of is called liquid waste. Liquid waste includes water used for washing, cleaning, and bathing at home, detergents, oils for food production, industrial chemical waste in liquid form, liquid waste from hospitals and farms, and waste water. So whatever liquid that we are using, which is in the form of water, oil, right? These are liquid waste, which comes in some or the other kind of a place from, right? Like oils from food production, industrial chemical waste, which comes out from where? From the industries. We get liquid waste from the hospitals, right? Moving forward, we have gaseous waste. Now, what are these? Moment being a gaseous waste, we understand, okay, something which is in the form of gas. The molecules are very, very loose, right? So smoke, dust, and harmful gases like carbon monoxide are called gaseous waste. Depending on its composition, the waste material can be further divided into biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Alright, now depending on this, we will have two more categories, children, which is biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Now, without even looking at the book and without even looking at this presentation, what we understand by biodegradable is something which can be easily, like, you know, rotten away, wherein the microorganisms would work and things would finish off, right? Can be used as a manure. Non-biodegradable can be, like, you know, things which will remain as it is, which will not melt, which will not get rotten. Let us read. Alright, what is biodegradable waste? So, biodegradable materials are those materials in the waste which break, dissolve, and decompose into soil within short periods. And what is the example? The examples are food waste, eggshells, chicken bones, leaves, grass, plants, etc. What are non-biodegradable waste now? It is surely the opposite of biodegradable. Non-biodegradable materials are those materials in the waste which do not decompose or dissolve in the soil. Alright? It does not get dissolved in the soil. Rather, what will it do? It will cause harm to the soil, and that will then turn out to be what? It will cause soil pollution. What are the examples? The examples are plastics and plastic bags, glass, cans, metal items, and styrofoam. See children, so many examples are there. That is the reason why these days, what are we doing? We are emphasizing so much on no use of plastics, right? If we have to decompose them, there are better ways of throwing them away, right? In a proper bin, which we will learn further in the chapter, when we move ahead in the chapter. Such materials can be recycled and used again. Therefore, it is important that such items should be segregated for recycling and not sent to landfill or burning. If we burn off these things, what will happen? It will cause, as I said, if we burn it off, it will cause air pollution. If we dump it in the land, it will cause soil pollution. So, lots of pollutions would take place. So, what will we do? It can be recycled. All of you have heard, you have read in your previous chapters, in your previous standards. What had you learned? You had learned about kabadiwalas. How these kabadiwalas, they come and they collect.